So we're going to begin by trying to define what is a place. And that might seem really simple. You might just spit out a bunch of words, you know, like somewhere in the universe, a spot, location on a map, even a specific place like your own house. Somewhere, anywhere, I guess, that you can find in the world. But here's the tricky thing about definitions. There are rules of making definitions. So firstly, you can't use the word in the definition. If I'm looking it up, I obviously don't know what the word means. So you can't say something like, a place is a place that... No, that's no good. It's also important to keep in mind what definitions are for. Definitions, firstly, tell us what things are. And more specifically, they're telling us what words mean. And even though it's a weird way to think about it, they're kind of telling you how your word and your thing are different from all the other words and things. So really, a good definition should try to exclude everything that isn't the thing being defined. And that's why rule number two is, the definition should be, as far as possible, specific enough to only apply to the thing or word you're defining. Here's an example of that. Let's say you're trying to define dog. Here's my dog, so cute. And a technical definition of a dog could be something like a small domestic animal. That is true, but it's not particularly helpful because that could also be a definition of a cat, a fish, a rabbit. And suddenly we actually don't know very much about what a dog is by that definition alone. So you might start to include some more specific words like canine family, fur. And as we get more specific, we get closer to the Wikipedia definition at least. But we're not trying to define dog, we're trying to define place. Let's go back to some of those original words, like this good one, location. Location's a great word. It sort of means the position of something on the earth. But it's not exactly the same thing as place. We know that because locations don't move. In fact, it's kind of their whole thing that they stay put. It's how we know where everything else is. However, a place like a school can move. This is pretty unlikely, but let's say tomorrow we bought a property on Bellevue Parade instead of Bellevue Parade and we decided we're going to move the school. It's possible. And in doing so, even if the school moved its location, it would keep its placeness as St. George Christian School. It would still be called St. George Christian School. It would still retain its student body and all the things that we know about the school. It would still be on Google Maps as St. George Christian School. Just the address will have changed. So it's almost like a place is a location plus something that elevates it beyond just the address. Elevates it beyond just the spot on earth, the particular land that it occupies. So let's start this again. So here's what we've got so far. A place is, and here's where you take your pick of location, spot, position, something that implies that it exists in the real world, not in your mind. You can put it on a map. It's got a latitude. It's got a longitude. It's got coordinates. Okay, this is geography. You get the picture. But it's not just the location. It's a location with some particular meaning or status, like a name, a proper noun. But I guess it doesn't have to have a name. It probably has a name. Maybe it doesn't. Probably it does. In any case, it needs to be unique. It needs to be known for something more than just its address. And we need a word for all this wish-washy stuff, name that isn't a name, that we can put in our nice, neat little definition of a place. If only there was a word for name, not a name. Oh, wait. Identity. A place is a location with an identity. So, defining place. Much trickier than it sounded at first, but we did it. So to finish up this video, one burning question. Is your bed a place? It might not seem like much, but it's going to mess with your head.